Hi, everybody. It is Tuesday, July 11th. We are in Napa, California, getting ready to head out in a little while to sound check and a show tonight, and then we drive off again afterwards to someplace. I have no idea where we are going because I just never get around to looking at the itinerary because I figure I have no say in the matter. So I just load up and wake up somewhere else. I'm looking forward to the show this evening because my friend Mario Cipollina is coming to the show tonight, who was the bass player in Huey Lewis in the News and one of my favorite bass players, a unique, unique style and a tremendous musician. And we haven't seen each other. God, I think it's been 20 years since we last saw each other. So he's coming to the show. So that'll be a great little hang afterwards before we head off on the road. But I was getting ready. I've got a couple of things prepared musically to put up. And I suddenly looked at the numbers there. And today, this video right now is number 1,400 of the videos since I started this channel. I mean, it's kind of unbelievable to me. I really don't kind of think about the numbers, but this really kind of caught me. I just went, 1,400 videos now. And so more than anything, I just wanted to say thank you to everybody who's come to this channel. It's been, for me, this was a kind of a lifesaver, godsend when the pandemic hit. And like everybody else, my world kind of shut down. All the sessions and tours that were in the book all disappeared. I mean, nothing was happening. And I remember just sitting at home trying to think, you know, what am I gonna do now? I've never had downtime in my entire life. And all of a sudden, here I was with downtime. So this all originated, and I've talked about it in the beginning, but so many people have come on over these past few years that maybe haven't really gone and checked out all the beginning stuff about this channel. But I had some people contacting me after we finished Phil Collins's last tour, the Not Dead Yet tour. And they were asking me, they said, you know, we saw you in Germany or we saw you in Brazil. And we were playing all stadiums at that point. I mean, these things were like massive, massive gigs. And I have in the background, I'm just my favorite piece of music, The Lark Ascending by Ralph Vaughan Williams. And this is Sir Neville Mariner and the St. Martin in the Fields Orchestra with Ilona Brown as the soloist on this. It's one of my go-to pieces for chilling. So I had people writing to me going, you know, we saw the show, it sounds amazing, because we had a great front of house guy, Michel Collins, incredibly great front of house mixer, but because of the nature of those venues, they couldn't maybe hear all the details of parts. And so I ended up having Michel send me a board mix, his just board mix from a show that we did in Adelaide, Australia. And I loaded it into my laptop and I plugged in my little, here, it's sitting right here next to me, my Bose speaker. And I had a little bass amp next to me on the floor, and I set my iPhone on my laptop right now. It's just leaning against the screen on my laptop. And what I chose to do at that point was play, I started with the first song of the show, and I played that where you could hear the song quietly coming from the speaker, but I mixed it so that the bass amp was a little bit louder so that I could show all the bass parts in detail. And the second day I did the second song, third day I did the third song, not with any intention other than just showing these few people that had questions what was going on this. And up by the third day, I had people writing to me going, we love your channel, man, your new YouTube channel. And I'm going, what are you talking about? I have no idea what they were talking about. And it just evolved into this. And then I got to the end of the show, except for one song. And I'm saving that song When the time comes for me to shut down this channel eventually, I'll probably do that as my last song, and that's Take Me Home. So that's the one song from the show that I have not performed. So it's one of these really interesting things that it just kind of took on a life of its own. And then I got to the end of the show and I kind of thought, I'm enjoying this, but now what? And that's when I started digging into my own archives, which I had never done. I'm not one of these people that, hold on, I'm gonna make sure I shut this off here. Good, I wanna make sure the ringer's off in case I don't wanna get a call in the middle of this and be shut down. I never think about my history in this business, even though it's, you know, it's like 53 going on 54 years of it. I never really had ever given a thought to it. I'm one of these people, I think about what am I doing today and what are we doing tomorrow? So all of a sudden I had to start addressing my history on this, pulling up, you know, Jackson Browne and Linda Ronstadt and Hall & Oates and Billy Cobham and all these different things. And it's become a real forensic adventure for me doing this channel because I'm out trying to find sites all the time that show what I have worked on so that I can kind of rediscover it. And it's been a fascinating journey of, you know, finding memories of studios, of musicians, so many who have passed now, just artists. It's been a unique experience to say the least. I cherish it. I relish it. The things that evolved out of this experience, the clubhouse that we formed from the YouTube channel and the incredible community that has grown out of this is something totally unexpected. Never dreamed that this would happen, but it is some of the nicest people I've ever known are in there. And the interest and care that they all have for each other is really something special. I had never recorded at home before the pandemic set in. I would always go to another friend's house. If somebody said, hey, can I send you some files and you can put some bass on it? I'd go, yeah, sure, no problem. Because I'd go over to friends of mine like John Gilliton, who has a really great home studio. And it was a great excuse for us to hang out and go out and have lunch. So, you know, I'd go over there and we'd work and then, you know, get up. And suddenly with COVID, that wasn't happening anymore. And I had a dear friend of mine contact me about doing a cover of Easy Lover, Phil Collins, Philip Bailey. And I said, man, I'd love to work on it with you, but I'm not set up for home recording. And the next thing I know, they sent me an SSL 2 Plus interface. And I contacted Steve Postel from our band, The Immediate Family. And he gave me an over-the-phone tutorial on GarageBand, which is really all I needed to do bass parts. And I ended up, during this whole period, recording. I've done probably about, I'd say, 18 albums during the course of this past couple of years. I'm in the middle right now of one for an artist, and he sent me 16 songs. So all my free days out here on the road, which there are very few, like yesterday I did two tracks for him. And I think I've done about 9 now out of the 16. So next day off or free day, I'll go take care of that. So that opened up to me and doing my book, all this stuff. But this channel really has taken on just a special meaning to me. The joy I get from doing the venue tours is really great because whenever people go to concerts, you know, you see the parking lot, you see the lobby, and you go to your seat and you see the show. So it's really fun to be able to explore all these buildings and show people the inner sanctum when possible, or show them when they're empty. And there's no stress or pressure to get to your seat and let, you know, the show's starting. And I have no intention of stopping this at all. It just, it's one of these things I wake up every day with just excitement about it. I've got a few more projects lined up. And it's interesting too, then I go to Wikipedia and I look at Wikipedia, and it's probably about half of what I've worked on that thing. So, I mean, I'm still trying to find other avenues, Discogs and AllMusic, and there's so many of these sites, and then people keep sending some stuff where they go, oh man, I love what you played on such and such album, and that's not even on any of that stuff. And then I go dig the album up and I go, oh yeah, I played on that. So, I mean, I feel very fortunate. I've worked really hard my whole career, but I feel very fortunate that when the opportunities became available, I was able to, you know, parlay those into my world. And so I just want to say thank you to everybody for, rather than just putting up one of those pieces today for number 1400, I just thought I would just give a shout out and say thank you so much to everybody who's come to this channel and seems to enjoy it and comes back all the time to it and has turned friends onto it. And I love when I'm out, you know, when doing gigs and stuff and people come up going, man, we love your YouTube channel and stuff. It's really, I never did this for ego. I just did this because it felt like the right thing to do at this point in my life, to be able to share my experiences and different things that I've worked on, some of which may help people that are up and coming that you know, have thought about, you know, doing this but weren't quite sure, you know, how you do it. And then they've gotten some information from me or from other people participating on this channel about they go, oh yeah, if they did it, yeah, I can do this too. So just a big thank you very much to everybody. When we get to the gig today, I will be putting up 1401 and I'll show up, check out the venue that we're at today, and then tomorrow I'll get back to music on here. But today I just wanted to use this as a moment just to kind of reflect on these past 1400 videos and the community that's grown from this, and say thank you all so much, you know. And then of course people expect me, thank you so much, but that's and that's a whole other discussion. It's in there, the explanation. Some people go, I don't get this finger thing. Well, there's a whole deep explanation as to where this whole thing evolved from. And it was a quirky thing that happened on Phil Collins' 2003 tour. And it just took on a life of its own. But I love this community, and I plan to be here for a long, long time. You'll have to just shut me off if you don't want to see me, but I'm going to be here. So I'm going to get ready, and we have work to do today, and I will be back later. Okay, thanks so much, everybody, though. Bye-bye.